Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at the New York Stock Exchange top 10 volume leaders from Monday's trading action. Now, in the pre-market this morning, the futures have rolled over. Dow futures currently down 240 points, so we are looking for some aggressive selling at the open on Wednesday morning. Our first stock this morning, Bank of America, already on a sell signal, holding support at 1641. It looks like that's going to break today, so we're looking for a move down to 1563 as our next target to the downside. On the upside, we become bullish on this stock on Wednesday with a close above 1751. Certainly not expecting that to happen, and that upper channel line will continue to move lower daily. Next up, we're looking at General Electric, which is trying to hold the October lows. And our next mathematical target is 2344. If that breaks on Wednesday, I'm moving back because we're down at the bottom of our projected trading range and we don't have any numbers on the screen right now. What I'm going to do is flip to the weekly chart to see when the next weekly target is, and that's at 2188. And so that's where we'd expect General Electric to go if it breaks through the first areas of support. Petrobras, and of course this is a very, very broken stock, so people here have been trying to do some bottom feeding, and of course to be successful in the stock market, you want to follow the best stocks, not the worst stocks. It's currently on a buy signal from a couple of days ago. That will change on Wednesday with a close below $6.55. Next up, we're looking at Vale, another broken stock here, and it's been on a buy signal for a few days. We're trying to get to 938. As our target, but may have a little problem. Yesterday was a bearish reversal day, which it was for a lot of stocks and indexes yesterday. We need to close below 811 to give us a new sell signal for Vale on Wednesday. And of course, if that doesn't happen, that lower channel line will continue to rise daily. Next up, we're looking at Alcoa, and this stock reported on Monday night and Tuesday morning. It was up in the pre-market, but yesterday it sat right down. It was up over 2% in the pre-market and ended the day down over 2%, so a 4% swing, having trouble up there at 1641. Looking down on Wednesday, we need to close below 1550 to give us a new sell signal for Alcoa. Next up, we're looking at KB Homes, down 16% and change on the day yesterday. And this was one of the major catalysts for the reversal in the market on Tuesday. Traded right down and closed just above the October highs there. Next target to the downside, if we take out 1328, which I think we'll do on Wednesday, 1250 is our next target to the downside. And of course, we're not looking for any opportunity to buy this stock at this time. Next up, Pfizer. Pfizer looks like it's put in a double top, had a bearish reversal day yesterday. Still on a buy signal, still closed above the upper channel line. A close on Wednesday below 3171 would give us a new sell signal for Pfizer. I've been bullish on gold stocks for the last while and really can't get any upward momentum here. We got caught at 469, had a bearish reversal day yesterday, traded down to the lower channel line on Tuesday. A close below 409 on Wednesday would kick us out of this stock. Looking at Freeport, and of course this has a gold component, it also has a copper component, and so copper is making multi-year lows at the moment. There we are down at the previous low, next target to the downside, 1875. A close on Wednesday above 2328 would give us a buy signal, not expecting that to happen. And last up this morning, we're looking at AK Steel, which is broken through the bottom of the panic zones and the October lows, and mathematical support at 469, we're heading for 313. Of course, if things were to turn around on Wednesday and we closed above 570, that would generate a new daily buy signal. Not expecting that to happen. And it's more than likely we're going to get to 313 before we get to 570. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Have a great day. And we'll be back tomorrow morning to look at the 10 most actively traded stocks on the Toronto Stock Exchange.